Why do you think the AI tools have not been as impactful as they could be? The US healthcare sector is going through a lot of different changes. And one of the things that is changing rapidly is how much we are investing in using AI for different aspects of healthcare. 10% of the US healthcare expenditure, $500 billion, is going each year to medical AI. That's to develop AI tools that can improve the healthcare sector in general, and specifically finding better solutions to treating diseases, trying to make the physicians more efficient. And a lot of changes that has happened with generative AI now makes the physicians a lot more efficient in terms of their documentation, in terms of how they can spend their time. You know, the goal is to spend more time with the patients. And we are seeing a lot of changes along the lines of, you know, having AI filling out the form for prior authorization, for instance. We are now seeing that we can use large language models and other AI tools to, you know, help physicians to spend less time on documentation and more time with the patients. One of the things that my lab, the Public Impact Analytics Science Lab, is working on is trying to figure out how to actually have AI tools that can decide about the best treatments, not just to make physicians productive by having them spend less time on forms and things like that, but also trying to give them recommendations about what medications or what treatments we should give to each patient. That is a layer of AI that needs a lot more attention and needs a lot of focus because it's not straightforward. You need to have the ability to understand the causation, the impact of different drugs on different patients, and try to develop tools that can impact the quality of care that the patient receives. We have done a lot of experiments in the Public Impact Analytics Science Lab, specifically with the Mayo Clinic, trying to figure out why AI has not been impactful. And the experiments are showing us that there are three specific barriers. So one of them is what we call algorithm aversion. This is the fact that humans and physicians in general do not like to listen to algorithms. Physicians try to mainly rely on themselves rather than the recommendations that come from the algorithms. The second issue that we have found is what we call human aversion. This is the fact that the algorithms a lot of times provide recommendations that do not match what physicians believe in, or do not match essentially human intuition. Then the third thing, which is the hardest one to address, is what I call causation aversion. A lot of these algorithms are developed by looking at the association that we have between different variables, between age, between race, between clinical factors, history, but they lack the level of causation that we require when we try to find out better treatments. So what we've done is that we're now trying to develop AI techniques that first learn about human intuition, and then we feed those learned methods to the AI system. And now we have an AI system that is at a higher level. It's not just built based on, you know, the data set, but it's also built based on human intuition. It's closer to their intuition, and they are more willing to listen to it and to follow it in their practice.